Hello friends, and welcome to the first video in our five-part series about SEO and website structure. This whole series will be all about how you can set up the pages of your website and the ways that they link between each other in order to get people to navigate through your website better and also make it easier for Google to understand what the most important pages are of your site, be able to send you some traffic from them. Full disclosure, this particular series has been on my to-do list to record for about 6 months, and I've only been doing YouTube videos for a year because it is a topic that is very important and also incredibly boring. So I'm going to do my best to explain this to you in a way that makes sense, in bite-sized ideas that fit all of these ideas together, hopefully without putting you to sleep. So bear with me and I'll explain to you in this video why website structure is important and how you can get started by thinking about this. Hey there, I'm Meg Casebolt, the founder of Love It First Search, where we help online entrepreneurs to show up in search results, then turn those new visitors into leads, subscribers, and sales. In this video today, I'm going to be talking all about how to organize the pages and the elements of your website in order to make it easier for Google to send traffic to you and understand what's important on your page, and also make it easier for the people who are visiting your page to understand what it is that you do and make them more likely to buy from you, because they understand what you want them to do. Now, when you make some of these adjustments to your website that I'll talk about today, these aren't just how to get more traffic to your website. This is also about creating a really strong user experience and making it easier for your visitors to navigate through your page. So some of the tactics that I'll share with you will help you to increase the time that people are spending on your page, decrease your bounce rate, which is when people come to your website and leave without looking around, and increase the number of pages that they're looking at on your site. So making sure that you're making it super clear to your users what you want them to do and how they can take the next step with you. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you probably know all about how to optimize a blog post, because that's a place that feels like a really simple place to start. It's writing a post and then inserting the keywords on all the places and getting the images into place. And that's very important. But once people get to that blog post, how do they navigate around your site? How do the pages of your website work together to give those new visitors a really great experience and to help them get to know you and what you do? And that's what we're talking about here with site structure, is how do people navigate through the different pages of your site, and how do you organize the ways that they're seeing those pages to have it make sense to them. Having a really clear site structure also helps with your SEO, because it helps Google to understand what's most important on your website. It helps it to find new content that you've created or any changes that you're making and index it quickly. So that way, if you write a new blog post or you include a new product, it will show up on Google faster. And it will also distribute your link authority around your key pages. So the ways that you're linking between your pages can also demonstrate to Google what the most important pages and products and posts on your website are, so that people are more likely to see those no matter where they land. Having a really clear idea of how all of your pages fit together can also prevent you from having duplicate content or from cannibalizing your own content, which is a fancy SEO way of saying ranking so much for one term that Google doesn't know where to send the traffic when people are looking for you. So when you're thinking about the architecture of how your page should be set up, I want you to think of this as a pyramid. So at the very tip top of the pyramid is your homepage. You only have one homepage on your website. That's the root domain of the site, meaning it's the part that just has a slash. There's nothing else that comes after it. And chances are, if people are visiting your website, they're probably going to see your homepage, because they're going to go up to the corner logo and click on that and go to your homepage in order to get an idea of what it is that you do. I will do an entire video on the SEO of homepages. God, I could do a month of videos on this, and I'll link that up when it's ready. But for right now, what I want you to think about is there is one homepage on your site, and that's the most important page in terms of how people navigate around your site, because no matter what page they come into, they're probably going to visit your homepage. The next level of your pyramid is your categories and subcategories. Now, this is especially important for e-commerce sites or people that are selling lots and lots of products. So when you go to Amazon, you can see up here, we have this category along the top that is the best sellers and the new releases and books and pet supplies. And these are, you know, you guys can also see that I really like protein bars, but you get this idea of these are the most important things that Amazon wants you to see when you get to that site. So if you're running a product-based business and you have a lot of different categories, or if you're running a media site where you're talking about a lot of different topics, categories should be the next level of importance in your site architecture and your navigation structure. But for those of us that are service businesses and we have just one service that we want to tell people about, or those of us that have simpler product lines, you don't necessarily need to include your categories in your main navigation the way that a place like Amazon does. This is maybe a place that second tier where you want to include, here's your services, here's the way you can work with me. So maybe instead of thinking of this as categories, if you aren't running a multiple product or multiple offer business, just think of this as the ways people can work with me. And then our third tier of our pyramid, the bottom level of our pyramid, is those individual pages and posts and products and portfolio items and apparently anything else that starts with the letter P, where these are really specific detailed items. These are blog posts that solve a specific problem. This is one individual product versus a category of products. This is a particular project that you worked on in your portfolio. This is a snapshot of what it is that you do and you sell, but it's not the overarching umbrella that you would find in your homepage or a collection of things that you would find in your categories. Now, if you apply this to your website and you think that the most important page on your website is your homepage, and then you have either your categories or your offers, and then you have those individual blog posts, it should be pretty easy to navigate throughout your website because we know what the most important pieces are. We also want to make sure that from your homepage to get down to some of those individual pages that are a little bit more specific, we don't want people to have to click forever and ever and ever to get there. We want a much more what's called flat architecture of websites so that you don't have to click more than four clicks away from your homepage to get to any page on your site. In fact, Google uses this, it's called your click depth. Google uses this information to figure out how important every page is. The closer it is to the homepage, the more important that is. So if you have a specific offer you're promoting, maybe you want to include that right on your homepage, a link to it, or a really popular category that people buy from you a lot, or a sale that you're running, you want to include that on your homepage. And then maybe you also want to include a link to that directly on your menu, so that way people can click to it right from your homepage without needing to click through, you know, okay, here are my services, and here's the different offers that I have, and then here's the one that it is. We want to make it as simple as possible for people to get to your most important things directly from your homepage. And even with those individual posts and products, we want to make it easy for people to find those too. So even if you want to have people click from your homepage to your blog to a specific blog post, make sure to have that blog set up so that way people can see the entire back catalog of your blog posts. I'll talk in future videos about how to organize your categories and your subcategories and your tags to make it easier for people to find the product or the post that we're looking for. But the idea here is that we don't want to have to click through 20 pages to find the thing we're looking for. Every page on your site should be four clicks or less from your homepage. This has been a very high-level explanation of how these different pages of your website work together. I will be back in future videos to talk specifically about how to choose what to put in your menu, how to organize your homepage to make it easier for people to figure out where they want to go, for Google to know what the most important pages are. I'll have a specific video just about categories and tags and another about the ways that you can use links throughout your website to make more sense to Google. So if you don't want to miss those future videos, make sure to subscribe to the channel, like this video, and I will be back next week with more tips about how you can make it easier for your website to be found and easier for people to buy from you once they get there.